Hello students, welcome back to Learn Again. In this video you will learn chapter number 12, Understanding the Earth, and our today's topic is Rocks and Minerals. So without wasting time, let's proceed. Well, have you ever looked at the rock and wondered how it came to be? The story begins about 4.5 billion years ago, as gas and dust come together to form the rocks that make up our planet, created from elements forged far off in a galaxy. Rocks really are the stuff of stars, and so are we. Rocks and minerals tell a story about our planet, our past. So let us know about them in brief. Minerals. A mineral is a naturally occurring inorganic substance which contains one or more elements with definite physical and chemical properties. The study of mineral is known as mineralogy. Quartz, feldspar, mica, and so on are the common rock forming minerals. Rocks. As you may already know, the earth crust is made up of rocks. If you look closely at rock, you will see that there are many different bits. Some bits are dull, whereas other bits are rather shiny. The main idea here is that all these components occur naturally. In other words, they are not made in factory or by human being. Rocks are composed of one or more minerals and include the hard and compact rocks like granite and diamond, as well as loose particles such as clay, mud, and sand. They have different colors, size, and textures. Rocks are also called as ore. The rocks which contain particular metallic mineral in large quantity, they are known as ores. For instance, bauxite is an ore of aluminum and hematite is an ore of iron. Rocks have been classified by the geologists into three major groups. They are igneous, sedimentary, and metamorphic on the basis of formation, appearance, and the kind of minerals which constitute them. Let us see igneous rock first. Igneous word is derived from the Latin word ignis, which means fire, as it refers to the rocks formed by the cooling and solidification of hot lava and magma. They are being formed till now because of the volcanic activity. They came to the existence first, or we can say that they were formed first time before the other rocks, and that is why they are called as primary rocks too. Igneous rocks are classified on the basis of its origin. Molten material or magma which reaches the earth's surface as lava through volcanic vents or fissures cools and solidifies, forming explosive or volcanic rocks. When the lava is exposed to the air, it cools rapidly and fine-grained crystalline rocks are formed, such as basalt and pumice. Sometimes molten material or magma may also cool and solidify below the earth's surface and makes intrusive or plutonic rocks. As the molten material within the earth cools slowly, larger crystals or coarse-grained crystalline rocks are formed. For example, granite and dolerite. Igneous rocks are not only crystalline in structure but also hard and compact. Some other characteristic can be they do not allow water to percolate through them. They are not formed in layers. They do not contain the remains of plants and animals, that is fossils. Well, fossils means remains of animals and plants in rocks. Sedimentary rocks. Sedimentary word is derived from the Latin word sedentum. Let us know about the formation of this rock. Sometimes fragments means pieces of broken rock, decayed remains of plants and organisms, and salt or chemicals are carried by running water, wind, and moving ice, and they are deposited in depression underwater. In the course of time, these all deposited materials forms the layer due to the accumulation of all these materials, and then they compress and harden with the aid of cementitious materials such as lime to form mechanical, organic and chemical sedimentary rocks. And that is why they belong to secondary group of rocks. The main difference between sedimentary and igneous rock is sedimentary rocks are softer than igneous rock and their structure is non-crystalline. Such rocks at times also contains fossils in between the layers of the sediment. Some of the examples of sedimentary rocks are sandstone, shale, conglomerate, mudstone, rock salt, limestone and coal. Metamorphic rocks. Metamorphic word is derived from the Greek word metamorphosis, which means change of form. When existing igneous and sedimentary rocks change their chemical and physical form due to intense heat and pressure, these metamorphic rocks are formed. But this process takes millions of years. And the interesting thing is, all the metamorphic rocks make extremely good building and construction material. Let us see some of the characteristics of this rock. Due to effect of heat and pressure, these rocks are often banded or layered. Metamorphic rocks are usually crystalline in structure and perhaps the hardest of all rocks. Percolation is quite impossible in these rocks. They do not contain fossils. These groups also belong to sedimentary groups of rocks as they are formed from existing igneous and sedimentary rocks. For example, granite changes to gneiss, sandstone to quartzite and limestone to marble. These are all the examples of metamorphic rocks. The rock cycle. Rock cycle is the continuation of forming rocks one after another. Due to heating, melting, erosion, deposition and chemical action, one group of rocks led to the formation of another group. And this cycle formation and development of these three types of rocks is known as the rock cycle. Let's know more about it. First of all, igneous or primary rocks are formed. Later, they are broken down into sediment by natural processes like weathering and erosion. These are deposited and compacted to form sedimentary rocks. Due to great heat and pressure, igneous and sedimentary rocks are transformed into metamorphic rocks. These sedimentary rocks may be buried again and melted due to heat from the interior of the earth and form magma. These metamorphic rocks may be broken down into sediments due to natural forces, later forming sedimentary rock and even buried again to form magma. In this way, the cycle continues the relationship between three rocks group. This entire process is powered by the energy of sun and involves processes both on surface as well as in interior of the earth. Now let us see the uses of rocks and minerals. Rocks are compositions of different minerals which are immensely valuable for the human being. These rocks are used to make roads and houses. Rocks like granite, sandstone and marbles are widely used as building materials. Minerals like natural gas, coal and petroleum or fossil fuels are used as source of power. Besides this, rocks have also made agriculture possible as soil is formed by the decomposition and degradation of rocks. Some rocks which are having mineral contents such as ores are used in different industries to extract iron, aluminium, gold, Uranus and so on. There are many chemicals which found in rocks which are used as fertilizer. Apart from all these, many rocks contain fossils which gives us information about our past. So dear students, we come to the end of this lesson. Next lesson we'll see in the next video. And hello, haven't you subscribed yet now? Please subscribe my channel and hit the bell icon so that you will get notifications of your new lessons. Till then, have a nice time. Thank you.